All right. That's pretty good. That's pretty good. That was pretty good. I might have to put Mr. Burgess on Fox News. You know, give him. I'll put Mr. Burgess up against Sean Hannity. He'll tear him up.
Tear me up. Now, was that a threat, Mr. President, or just a preview of what's to come in terms of your desire to intimidate conservatives? Joining me now with Reaction, Fox News political analyst Kirsten Powers, radio talk show host with the Salem Radio Network, our friend Dennis Prager. Guys, welcome back to the show.
Hi, Sean.
Good to be here.
Kirsten, imagine little old me ever saying, I'm going to put so-and-so against Obama. We'll tear him up.
I know, poor Sean.
Look, I miss the attacks. It was a great promo every time he did it.
But in all seriousness, what the White House did was completely despicable. And I think now people are starting to see, we got the taste of it early on. This all started pretty quickly after he was in office. It was just not even quite a year into office that they launched this war on Fox News. And the thing that I love about that clip that you showed of him at the beginning is that he says, there's this one news station, I have one news station that attacks me all day long. Now, setting aside whether it's true that he's being attacked all day long, it's one. and he's complaining that out of all of the media, there is one place that allows people to say things about him that he doesn't like. Let's get a little perspective. I think any president would be happy if that was their situation.
I think that's really well said. And I've always felt, Dennis, that he's pretty thin-skinned and he doesn't really want any criticism. He likes the worship that he gets from the rest of the media.
Look, this is actually a trait, and I say this about the president all the time, and it's not personal. He's a man of the left. The left needs a bubble to succeed. If there is one professor at a university who's conservative, he's a problem. If there is one form of media that is not liberal, that's a problem. Do you know, I saw a list of the 200 most prestigious colleges, if such a thing you can even speak of, and not one of the graduation speakers this year was a conservative, not one. They don't want to hear us because they have to live in a hermetically sealed intellectual and moral world in order to prevail. And that's why your existence and the existence of talk radio, which of course we're both on, are such anathema to them.
And the blogosphere too. I mean, there is a new journalism out there and it's having a pretty dramatic impact. Kirsten, we just had on Juan Williams, and mm-hmm. I pointed out what Eric Holder said, that talking about James Rosen, this is not something I've ever been involved in, heard of, or would think would be wise policy, and that's targeting journalists. We now know that, in fact, he did. Then you go back to Fast and Furious. Do you think that Eric Holder lied under oath, and do you think there should be ramifications for that?
Well, if he lied under oath, there should be ramifications, though I don't think that he—I think he should be gone regardless of whether he lied under oath.
So you think he did, though?
That's not the standard. It's not completely clear to me what he was technically saying. If he was just technically saying, I signed this warrant, but it was just to gather this information, and then we would make a decision after that, then that's different. So it's just not clear to me exactly technically how it played out.
Right. Let me play for both of you an ad that was put out by the RNC and get your reaction to this, because as you put all these things together, it's really beginning to look pretty bad. And I want to ask you what you think of this.
I first learned about it from the same news reports that I think most people learned about this. I think it was on Friday.
What day did you learn?
The same day the president did.
From news reports?
Correct.
So no one in this building told you?
That's correct.
Okay.
Who was responsible?
I don't have that name, sir. That I don't remember, to be honest with you. I'm not sure what you're asking, sir.
Don't remember again.
I'm not there to go ask a set of questions of people what happened, when, who, and how.
But that's the first we've heard of it.
Why they didn't, I don't know.
No one in the White House was aware.
This happened on my watch. I do not accept responsibilities for all the actions.
But I did not know any of the details at that time. I wouldn't say nobody's saying that, but the... or at least suggesting it.
With all due respect, you were there, though.
I was there.
I've decided to follow my counsel's advice and not testify or answer any of the questions today. What day did the conversation take place?
I'd have to look back at my notes on that, sir.
You've got notes on that?
I'd have to try to find them.
Do you have notes or don't you have notes?
I don't know.
I first learned about it from the same news report.
I have not done anything wrong.
What I continue to believe is that ultimately the buck stops with me. I'm going to be accountable.
Dennis Prager, where does this end politically?
Well, it's important to note that, on a sad note, that that montage is not going to be seen by New York Times readers. It's not going to be seen by most other cable news or any other, perhaps, cable news network, and certainly not the mainstream media. So we have to understand that what we perceive as obvious, and it is to me morally and politically obvious, is not necessarily the case for the rest of the country. The New York Times has essentially moved on. The Los Angeles Times has moved on, NBC, ABC, CBS have moved on, and that's what they're hoping will take place. Remember, the president has the entire media with him. When the New York Times revealed things about our drones and about Stuxnet, and then Senator Kerry,
yeah,
head of the Senate Foreign Relations Committee, condemned the New York Times for a terrible breach of security, nothing happened.
All right, Kirsten,
so we have to remember that what we understand is true is not being purveyed as such in the rest of the country.
Good point, Kirsten.
Oh, politically, I think this will have an impact in terms of really ginning up the base of the Republican Party, and it could have an impact. But I think Dennis is right. I don't think most liberals or Democratic-based voters are probably following it as closely.
All right, guys, thank you both. Appreciate it.
Yeah.